Hopefully everyone is doing well. My name is EQ, aka the Certified Gem Hunter, and welcome to Stonkaholics. Now in this video, we're gonna get a little bit more technical than usual. I get this question asked a lot. Yo EQ, I know what the Fibonacci retracement is, but how exactly do I use it? And is there a way to use it when it's going up and down as well? The answer to both questions is yes, and we're gonna go through all of it right now. By the end of this video, hopefully you should be able to use the Fibonacci retracement a little bit better. If you want to learn more about trading and how to trade, make sure to check out our premium trading group. That link is going to be in the bio, in the description, and in the comments, and I'll probably put it up top as well. And also, if you didn't get a chance to, make sure to throw a like on this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Let's roll the intro real quick. So in this video, we're only going to be focusing on Bitcoin and on the daily chart. We're going to be watching the long-term movements because they're a little more accurate than watching an hourly chart, for example. And I'm going to show you how you would have been able to track the long-term movements of Bitcoin and know essentially where price was going to fall and where it could potentially fall based on the harmonics and the typical price movement when it's falling within the harmonics of the Fibonacci. So when you're on TradingView, you have this helpful little tool here. It is called the Fibonacci retracement. It's your golden tool. Now you're going to notice my Fibonacci looks a little bit different than yours because I have some custom settings for the Fibonacci extension. If you want to get access to those settings, make sure to check out our premium trading group where you'll be able to get access to all of that information. I go into long in-depth videos about the Fibonacci and other trading strategies and tools. Now when you're using the Fibonacci, we can start at the first part of this move in December 15th. Where we got our first impulse move. So we can start our first Fibonacci from the bottom of the move and stretch it all the way to the top of the move. But before we get into this really deep, what a Fibonacci does is it allows you to see potentially where price can pull back to and where the dip can pull to, depending on if it's going up or down. Now the Fibonacci is really great when you're wanting to find ways to buy the dip where you think things can top out, when you're trying to find buy in and buy out opportunities for dollar cost averaging, so many other things that the Fibonacci comes in handy with. So when you want to trace a Fibonacci for a move going up or a bullish move, you want to start the Fibonacci from the bottom of the move to the top of the move. Now when you do the bottom to the top of the move, you're going to see these numbers pop up down here. Now essentially what they're going to mean in terms of crypto is anytime that you see price land on the 50, more than likely that could be a potential sign of a continuation pattern. If you see price drop to the 6180, that is known as the golden ratio number. That is a really good area for a DCA buying in. And then the 7860 is our favorite number. That's the number we want to see for large impulse moves so we can get all the way up to the take profit 3. The 7860 is my go-to number. If I see prices drop to the 7860 and start to hold support, that's where I'm adding the majority of my buying value or selling value depending on the opportunity we're talking about. But in this situation, we're talking about buying. So yeah, I'm going to be getting my buying opportunities ready in the 6180 and the 7860. And you can also have buys ready in the 50 if you want to play that continuation pattern. Now we can see based on this continuation, if I would put these lines here, you have a bull flag continuation pattern. The bull flag is able to break once price holds at the 50 Fibonacci. And we get our nice impulse leg, which takes us right to our take profit 2, basically right on the head. So when we bring this Fibonacci up to the next area, first off, we can see that this did not fulfill the full Fibonacci. When we drag this up and we bring this top to the next high, you can see that the price didn't even reach this take profit 1. And what's a little more interesting about that is when you bring this back down and you stretch this price out from here, from the bottom of this move to the top, to the first top of the move, the golden pocket and price basically was holding perfectly at the 6180 ratio. And if you are to bring this up to the high of these moves, price pretty much got perfectly to the 7860. And ideally, you're going to want to start this buy just a little bit higher. And you can see the 7860 bounce was the perfect ideal buying opportunity when we start to see price move back up based on long-term movement. So it's really ironic, and this is why this buying opportunity was so strong, because based on this long-term Fibonacci, this was ideally the golden number and where everyone was looking to buy. Once we got that lower wick, you can see it did not last very long, and every time price got relatively near this area, the buying spots, the buys, and the spots were eaten up. So that's how you know that this was a strong move, and that people were buying this, and that this was a retracement looking to get up into the next level. Now where the Fibonacci also comes in handy is when you see some sort of break in trend. So let's clear these lines out real quick. And let's say that we were watching this trend right here where you have higher highs and higher highs and you have your lower highs. Now, this was eventually broken out and you had a trend break, and this trend break was not able to get back into this area. Once you had that trend break, this could be a good time to test a bearish Fibonacci. When you want to test the bearish Fibonacci, you want to go top to bottom on the move. So I would have started from this point and dragged this down. Now, when I dragged this down and pulled this out, you can see that price at the 61.80 would have bounced at the 57, almost 58K range, and at the 78.60 would have hit around 60K. Price dragged up to pretty much 60K flat, and once it hit that 78.60 in the golden pocket is what we like to call it in between these two ranges, that's where we saw the ultimate sell-off and the last leg before we saw the major dip. So we could have seen this happen if we used a Fibonacci retracement knowing that price broke this trend. Now, because price was able to break out of the rising wedge, that's what was able to confirm that we could use the Fibonacci to see that if we were following a harmonic pattern, then we should see the selling opportunity hit around this general area. Now, we see a huge sell-off, and what happened with price, ironically enough, once this sold off, it came all the way down to the take profit 3, which is normal to see when things get near the 7860. And that's where price was able to hold around the 33K range. Now, we did get down to around 29K. But again, you can see these buying opportunities were eaten up when they presented themselves. It was not around very long, and this was the area that whales really wanted to accumulate, was the take profit 3 for the bearish. Now you have your accumulation going on, and you can reset your Fibonacci and take these lines back out. And getting into the latter move, we're looking back into bullish movement, so we can start from the bottom to the top. And we go bottom to top on this move. What do we see? We see a Fibonacci bounce at the 50, which is going to be a signal of continuation. And that continuation pattern, we got a buy signal as well from the stock bot. And we got a nice pump from the 50 all the way up to the TP2. And basically was able to take profit in a perfect area. And we had two tests and a final retest at the take profit 2, which would have been a good signal since it was a continuation that you more than likely weren't going to get to the take profit 3. And again, because it hit that continuation pattern, we can bring this up. Drag this Fibonacci upwards, see where price is currently at and what we're testing. And at the moment, we still have some room to go down based on the Fibonacci. And this is the current move, and this is what we're looking for in terms of buying opportunities at the moment for Bitcoin. This is why we wanted to go over the Fibonacci, because if you're watching this video within the first couple days to weeks, you'll be able to get a really solid buying opportunity. Whereas if you're watching this later, this is going to be a really good educational opportunity to see what happens with price moving forward. Now we're starting to see this sell-off again. We saw a sell-off and some weakness. We're breaking this trend line. We're going to see what happens with this trend based on the bottom trend, which would be around here. And this would be an ascending triangle that was broken. Now, if this continues to push down, I do want to see price maybe hit the 51K to 47K range. This is going to be the golden pocket. So anything in this area is going to be a really solid DCA buying opportunity. Obviously, that's not financial advice. None of this is financial advice. These are just recommendations and probably what I'm going to be doing, but this is not advice by any means. But this is going to be looking like a really solid buying opportunity and DCA opportunity within the golden pocket. Now, we can hold on the 50. It is possible. So make sure to have a little bit of buying power ready if you're trying to get into that, if you're trying to get into the buying power, buying the dip. But what I'm looking for the sweet spot is the 51K down to 47K area. Maybe put a DCA in every 1,000, and every time it hits, buying a little bit here, buying a little bit there until it starts to pull back up. Now, if this does want to fulfill and fall into one of these Fibonaccis, that's a great thing to see. And that's very, very healthy, because then we can push to the take profit 2 or take profit 3. Now, the take profit 3 for this move is around 95,000. So if we were to pull down to, let's say, 47, 48K, we could have a really strong impulse move up to this 95K to 100K range. And that's not going to be anything far-fetched, because the market pulled down enough on a long term that we have the long term pull and the longevity within the technicals to make a move like this, where we can go up more than 2x in one huge fucking move. So this is why we're watching this right now. I know a lot of people are freaked out, but remember, be greedy when others are fearful. So you want to use this opportunity to potentially buy in and take advantage of these dips when everyone else is freaking out and panic selling. Dollar cost average your way in and be patient, and know that patience will typically win this game. Especially if you have faith in crypto and the longevity of crypto, you shouldn't be worried about waiting a couple months or maybe even a couple of years to score out and get some money. And hopefully this video on the Fibonacci retracement did help you learn a little bit more about the Fibonacci, as well as where we're sitting in the market and what you can look for moving forward. If you want to learn more about trading, make sure to check out our premium trading group. That link is going to be in the description and the bio and in the comments, and the link that I'm going to leave on top of the video. If you didn't get a chance to already, make sure to throw a like on this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. Hopefully you have a great morning, afternoon, or evening, depending on wherever you're watching this in the world, and have a great day.